apologies for the dour mood you found me in when last we met, but I've perked up since then. Found myself a new purpose. At least something to keep me occupied while in Mornstead. I'm going to be a traveling merchant. Please, peruse my wares. Hopefully you'll see something of interest. Some might use the word scavenger, true, but that sounds somewhat judgmental, don't you think? I'm just putting to use that which has been discarded. You could even say that there's a sort of nobility in it. Well, perhaps just a little. Hello again, friend. May your path be blessed. Some might use the word, but I'm just putting... You could even... Well,
the Descriers of the harboring fundamental misinterpretations of Aureus's divine will and works. Many of the Mornstead nobles entombed in this crypt followed their teachings, believing it was the light of Aureus, not its stonework, which maintained this great structure. And yet, despite their ignorance, Aureus has allowed the bridge to stand. Is that not a sign of his benevolence? Our holy work continues, Lamp.
Fellow sanctified vessel, may Aureus's divine radiance flow through me and into you.
Our holy work continues, Lamp-bearer. Let Aureus's will be done.
You serve a higher purpose, Crusader. To strive in darkness, in... While even the handling of such items is objectionable, all facets of this heterodoxy must be exposed. While even the handling of such items is objectionable, all facets of this heterodoxy must be exposed. While even the handling of such items is objectionable, all facets of this heterodoxy must be exposed. Two fellow crusaders accompanied me to Mornstead. One, a paladin who sacrificed himself to facilitate your resurrection. The other, a harrower who revealed herself to be an apostate and thief. when she stole the apparatus with which I am able to converse with the Council of Overseers. An apparatus I would see returned to me by your hands. Howard Dervla can be found in the tenebrous bowels of the mine, a fitting place for one who has turned her back on Aureus Light. Whatever poisonous lies Derva may spit at you, heed them not, for they are nothing but the foul blasphemies of a fallen knave. If the abominable Rogar and heretical sentinels were not already reason enough to demand Mornstead's cleansing, consider those feculent savages who wallow in that swamp, for there is no place within Aureus Light for such beasts. Death is a merciful release in the face of such a loathsome existence. Whatever poison, for they are nothing but whatever poisonous lies, Dervam.
Shadowed halls of the past. Their delights now yours to indulge in, bearer of the lamp. Chosen bearer of the lamp, like you, I serve. The lamp only then.
Radiance, judgment. Our Immaculate Lady will bring redemption.
Ah, you again. Gerlinde found herself a place to do a little business. She hasn't seen any other Groak since arriving in this shithole kingdom. But Groak or human, sturdy armor and lethal weapons are a universal language. Speaking of business, Gerlinde has something you might be able to help with. She's looking for some items. This whining bag of bones left in Mornstead a long time ago.
Gerlinde is undeserving of what she seeks, traveler. And self-centered besides. You would do well not to aid her in.
You know full well the agony Gerlinde can inflict on you as long as you wear those manacles, Sparky.
My name is not...
Silence! Annoying as he is, Sparky does possess certain very rare knowledge, which he refuses to share. But he carves this knowledge in crystal. And now Gerlinda wants those crystal tablets to help in her runesmithing. So, if you find any in your travels, bring them to Gerlinda and she'll do right by you.
As I would not to Gerlinda, I will not reveal the locations of the tablets to you, traveler, even upon pain of death.
Just watch your step. Moonstead is a land awash.
If in doubt, much as he might think.
My offer stands, as long as, after all, what man?
come to Aureus, my child. Yes. Enter my embrace. Oh, may your flesh sustain my divinity. Bless you. Bless you.
Onwards you march, eh? I hope it's not for any kind of glory, because you won't find a sniff of that in Mondstadt. And certainly I hope it's not in the name of the hallowed Sentinels, because take my word for it, they're no better than the Rhodar. I've got many a scar to prove it. Whether you've embraced Umbral or struggle against it is none of my concern. Power is a sweet temptation, and the lamp will grant you that, sure enough. But don't confuse that with loyalty. Still, I'll not deny. I owe Umbral for giving me what it did. So the vestiges will be minded as long as I'm able. Name's Byron, by the way. I'll be around. Always am. Name's Byron.
some help. The sorcerer I was traveling with said the trinket I wore was actually some kind of ancient magical accessory. Said it would toughen my skin against harm if I let him reinvigorate it with his sorcery. As you can see, he did that sure enough. Stupid bastard. But he was a stupid bastard with coin, and the mercenaries got to make a living. Wilmark wanted protection for a journey to Mondstadt. He thought there was powerful magic here for the finding. But the coward ran off when some creatures appeared soon after I started petrifying. They couldn't take my head, but hopefully they hunted him down and made a latrine out of his. So, looks like my blade's for hire again, when I can swing it. Get this damn thing off me, and I'll be in your debt. And who doesn't appreciate having a favor in the pocket? Get this damn... And who doesn't appreciate having... Get this... And who doesn't appreciate... Get this... And who doesn't appreciate... Oh, fuck it all!
Our holy work continues.
Fellow sanctified vessel, may Aureus' divine radiance flow through me and into you.
Our holy work continues, lamp bearer. Let Aureus' will be done.
As I would not, I will, even upon pain of death.